greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and the Savior Jesus Christ. In French, as usual, we say, je vous salue tous au nom de notre Seigneur et Sauveur, Jesus Christ. For the Jews who are listening to me, shalom, shalom. And I believe that today we will be blessed as we are continuing with our series of why are we not reaching out the world by the gospel. And the one of the gift we spoke in last week was about a prophetic gift. And today, by God's grace, we're going to release some insight about Israel, Israel as a nation, and what God has spoken about Israel as a nation, because we really want to know some of the details. As last week, we had an opportunity to define what is prophetic, what is a prophetic gift. As we say, it is to speak forth the message of God to his people. To speak forth the message of God to his people. I believe that there is a word of the Lord as specifically for Israel as we're speaking now. And I just thank God I'm wearing now a color of blue and white, which symbolize nation of Israel, as well as behind me there is a flag. We thank God for this nation. And Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 to 2, as we know, this is a powerful verse which I consider as our main verse. God, who at many times and in many ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophet, he spoke to our forefathers by the prophet, as in these last days, in these last days, spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the whole world. He spoken to us by the mouth of the prophet in the past, but in the last days, in this time, he has spoken to us through his Son. So we have, last week we gave a little bit of some of the reason and the purpose of the gift of the prophecy, to reveal the will of God. And it's there to edify, it's there to exhort, it's there to comfort men. And the prophetic gift as well revealed the past events, such as Moses was revealed by God the books of Pentateuch. We know the book, which is it's coming from Deuteronomy chapter 31 from verse 24. Deuteronomy chapter 21 verse 24 is confirming that the book of Pentateuch, of the Torah, or the five books of Moses, were written by Moses. And Stephen and Peter speaking to the crowd in Acts chapter 2 verse 14 to 36, and chapter 7 from 1 to 60. And we see, and it's from those verses that we've discovered that, and that way we see the prophetic has been released. Moses was revealed the things of the beginning, how God created the heavens and the earth. So the prophetic is extremely important. It can reveal as well what happened in the past, and it reveals as well the spiritual things and human is heart. And Acts chapter 2 verse 36 and chapter 3 verse 19 to 21, where we see and Peter say, repent and be converted, that your sins may be blot out, that the time of refreshment may come from the presence of the Lord, that you may send Jesus who was preached unto you, that heaven must receive unto the time of refreshment of all things. So we have seen these things at the time of restoration of all things. We have seen these things coming, and Peter prophesying, Stephen prophesying in front of the crowd. And also we see as well the gift of prophecy reveals the future of a person, reveals the future of a nation, and reveal as well the future of the world, reveals the future of the world. If you have your Bible, please turn with me in Matthew chapter 24. That Jesus is speaking, Matthew chapter 24 from verse 3 to 51. Matthew 24 verse 3 to 51. We just want to read a couple of verses in the beginning. And Jesus said to them, do you not see all these things? Assuredly I say to you, no one stone shall be left there upon another that shall not be thrown down. Now as he sat on the Mount of Olives, his disciple came in privately, saying, tell us, when will these things be, and what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? And Jesus answered and said to them, take care that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end it is not yet. So in verse 1, we see that Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and his disciple came up, showing him the buildings of the temple. They're showing the building of the temple. Jesus said to them, do you not see all these things? I should have said to you, no, not one stone shall be left there upon another. So we spoke about in the beginning of our series that in the 70s we see the temple being destroyed. And Jesus spoke about this. He spoke about this. This prophetic reveals the things and that will come to pass in the future. And then we also see the battle of Jericho, where God revealed himself to Joshua, the strategies and how he's going to break down the wall, to bring down the wall of Jericho, also overcome this and take control of the city. So we see the prophetic comes and release those things. Okay, so let's come back now to Israel. Israel as a nation. I believe there is one thing in Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 9b, says there is nothing new under the sun. There is nothing new under the sun. So if you and I as Christian, as Jews, we are trying to understand what is happening in Israel, remember one thing. There is nothing new under the sun. So you may ask yourself a question. Why am I interested about Israel? Because I'm an African. I want to say to you one thing. I'm interested about Israel right now because Jesus and the Jews, they found refuge in Africa. It was specifically in Egypt they found refuge. So Africa has been a place of accommodation of the Jews for a long time. And Israel is also God's measuring rod and blueprint for what he's doing in the world. And it is helping us to understand the eschatology. So Israel as a nation, it is God's blueprint. If you and I want to understand the eschatology, we have to go back to Israel to understand where Israel is right now. Where Israel is standing right now. So if we get back to those things, we'll be able to understand what is God's time, what God is saying to the church of God. And let's look at here, Israel as a blueprint of God. As a Deuteronomy chapter 7, from verse 6 to 7. Deuteronomy chapter, if you have your Bible, please open with me. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verses 6 to 7. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6 to 7. We're going to read by God's grace. For you are a holy people to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for himself, a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth. We see now and the election of God. Why God has chosen Israel. So you and I may ask us a question, why God is choosing Israel? From verse 7 we see that, the Lord did not set his love on you, nor choose you because you are more in number than any other people. For you were the least of all the peoples, because you were the least of all the peoples. I pray that now as we are sharing this series about Israel, it is not that we should be called to be boasted. If I'm a Jew, I'm not called to be boasted because, you see, I'm a Jew right now and I've been chosen by God. No, God is choosing you because you are a list among all the people of the earth in that time. It's based on God's election. It's not by works, brother. It's by grace. It's by grace of God. If you are Jew, it's by grace of God that you have been chosen. It's not by works. So I'm supporting Israel right now, this as a nation, because Jesus was a Jew. And I pray daily to the God of Israel. Wow. I pray daily to the God of Israel. Okay, so let's see here what's happening in Israel. I'm reading right now here, Israel Today of June 2014. Rabbi Shlomo Avina states this. At the end of April, the 9-month time frame for U.S. brokered peace talk came to a close. And once again, nothing was achieved. Nothing was achieved. And he said this, nearly 50% of the lands claimed by the Palestinians have been transferred to their control since the Oslo Accord of 1993. But the atmosphere has only become more hostile. Israel needs to find a different way. Israel needs to find a different way. The Arab are not a problem. We are our own problem. That's what he's saying. So my brothers and sisters and Jews and Christians, we need to find an alternative way. What is God is telling us as we are approaching to the feast of Yom Kippur, which is the day of atonement, of repentance. And so as we are approaching between this month of Yom Kippur, what is God is telling us? Because we are heading into the time of repentance. We are heading into the time where we have to open ourselves into God and lay aside the sins that is taking us away from God and see which way, what really God is approaching us as believers, as Christians, as Jews, what God is telling us. So we see in a history, when we're reading the Tanakh is include the Old Testament, which contain the Torah, which is the 5 books of Moses, and Nevi'im, which is contain the prophets, and the Ketuvim, which is the writing of Brit Kadash, which is also called for the Christian the New Testament. And so I've understood the covenant made by God with the nation of Israel, the consequences of breaking this covenant, and different strategies that God used to reconcile his people, to reconcile himself with his people, and the different strategies that God used to retake possession of the land as far as is concerned. The way God has raised prophets, he has raised warriors, has provided different strategies to take possession of the land. So, when we read the old Bible, we see the history of Israel and how God operates, the covenant that God made with the nation of Israel, the covenant that he made. We see here in Genesis chapter 12, and God spoke to Abraham, so get out of your country, from your family, from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great. And you shall be a blessing, and I will bless those who bless you. I will curse him who curses you. In you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. So we see here, and God is blessing from an individual, is blessing a nation, also from a chosen nation, is blessing nations of the world. So we see God choosing an individual to bless us, an individual as well as the body of Christ, as the church, as the nation as well. So we see God is choosing as well as a nation to use it for his glory, to be a blessing for the rest of the nation, as he used and Israel as a blessing to all the nation of the world by the person of Jesus Christ, who is appointed, and we see the gospel being preached around the globe via Israel as a nation. So God has appointed this nation for his purpose. That's for his reason. So there is no question to ask why God has chosen Israel. Why only Israel? Why not us? It is God's election. It's God's decision. We can't even question about it. He says he's choosing Israel because he was the least among many people. So that's, I believe, God he has has come right now in the stage as is inspiring as this word. I believe and I sense that it strongly in my spirit that God is calling us as a Christians and Jews to read the scriptures, to consult the scriptures, to consult and to find out really what is happening right now. Why the nations are raising against us, why the people are raising against us. Also, what is happening? We see Christians as well. Christian and Jews, they're coming together. Christian and Jews, they're coming together. What is happening? What is the meaning of this? In the midst of this struggle, we see Christian and Jews, they're coming together. And what is happening as well? Why the rest of the nation who used to be with us, they are against us now. What is happening? What God is telling us. I believe with my small understanding of the scriptures, and I would like to give this answer here. And Deuteronomy chapter 28 from verse 1 and verse 7 says this: and it will be, if you shall listen carefully to the voice of Jehovah your God, to observe and to do all these commandments which I commanded you today, Jehovah your God will set you on high above all the nations of the earth. And Jehovah shall cause your enemies that rise up against you to be stricken before your face. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. So now let's see here the covenant of God. What's happening? Where people, they've broken the covenant. Deuteronomy chapter 28 from verse 15 to 21, Bible says this: it shall be, if you will not listen to the voice of Jehovah your God, to observe and to do all his commandments and his statutes which I commanded you today, all this curse shall come on you and overtake you. You shall be cursed in the city and cursed in the land, in the field. Brother and sister, we have question to be asked if we are keeping God's word. We are keeping God's commandment. Jews and Christians, are we keeping God's commandment? The things that happen in Israel, if they break out this commandment, we will see the consequence of that. The nation are raising and stability of the nation are raising. And we see those things coming to pass. And Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, say something. Yeshua HaMashiach says something about Jerusalem. Because you may be asking yourself a question, what really happened? What really happened? Why these things are happening in Israel? In the first century, Jesus Christ is crucifixion. In Matthew chapter 27, verse 24 to 26, Bible says something, yeah, very important. But when Pilate saw that, it gained nothing, but rather that a tumult was made, and he took water and washed his hands. He washed his hands before the crowd, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. I am innocent of his blood. I am innocent of the blood of Jesus Christ. I am innocent. So, you see it? Then all the people answer, they say, let his blood be on us and on our children. Let his blood be on us and our children. Then he released Barabbas to them, and when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Now we see Matthew chapter 23, verse 37 to 38. Jesus saying this, all Jerusalem, 23, verse 37 to 38. Jesus is saying, O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, who kills the prophet and stones to death those who have been sent to her, how often I wanted to gather your children together as and gather a chick under her wings, but you didn't want to. Look, your house is left to you deserted, abandoned. Your house is left to you deserted, abandoned. But I sense in my spirit that God is speaking to us here, because he has appointed his son Jesus. He has appointed him in this last days. Hallelujah. And Deuteronomy, if you want to read why Jesus Christ, how God has appointed Yeshua HaMashiach in this time, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15 and 18 to 19, Bible says, Jehovah your God raised up to you a prophet from the midst of you, of your brothers, one like me. To him you shall listen. I will raise them up, a prophet from among their brothers, one like you. And I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that they shall command him. And it shall happen, whatever men will not listen to my words, which he shall speak in my name, I will require it of him. And Acts chapter 3 verse 23 says this, and it shall be that every soul who will not hear that prophet shall be destroyed from among the people. Brothers and sisters, Jews and Christians, listen to the word of the Lord. I believe, I sense in my heart,